money has been defined to be desire capitalized, and as far as I am concerned, I am content to accept this definition. I have thought of it in all ways, and I have concluded after consideration of every circumstance connected with the subject that the definition is satisfactory. I am confident that if you will think of the matter, you will, as a necessary consequence, come to the same conclusion. In a genuine inquiry, the conclusion is not arrived at without some consideration of opposite views. In fact, those views must be considered if we are to come to a satisfactory conclusion. Having regard, therefore, to the interesting nature of the question before us, it will be agreed that it deserves to be fully considered and must be looked at from every standpoint. It demands that everything that can be said about it shall be considered, and that anything which may in any way help us to an opinion shall be taken into consideration. In point of fact, must be taken into consideration. Limited space, however, forbids my enlarging upon the question in the manner I would like, so that I must be content to leave out some considerations of which a great deal might be said, and respecting which there might perhaps be a disagreement. I shall consider this question more fully in another place. Parachange. Let us consider a few points, and I shall be content to leave the further consideration of the question to the reader. A great writer speaking on this subject of money points out that in view of a future exchange, money is as it were our security. For he says it is necessary that he who brings it should be able to get what he wants. If the reader will take into consideration the full meaning of the last sentence, he will see that what he wants is but another way of saying what he desires. Again, another authority declares that coined money is a kind of bill or order payable at the will of the bearer. In the like manner, still another writer states that a coin must be considered as a bill upon all the tradesmen in the neighborhood. That is, if I have received a coin for services rendered to somebody else, I can have in return anything I desire which is equal in value to it. A fourth authority says money is a warrant which gives the bearer the right to draw from society when he desires services according to the value of the coin. Similar questions on the nature of money have been answered by various other writers in the same manner, so that I have concluded that the definition referred to is tolerably accurate, and it cannot be said that I have come to an unsatisfactory conclusion, and I hope you are satisfied. Nowadays, most of the transactions of commercial and industrial life are carried out as far as possible by means of various forms of paper money, the most important of which in this country is the check currency, with which our banking system provides us.